Hello dear students, and welcome back in our biology session. So in our previous video we have discussed about the some cell organelles, we have discussed about the 5 cell organelles, and now today we will discuss the remaining cell organelles. In that today first we will discuss about the lysosomes. Okay, so what is mean by lysosomes and what is its function, let's discuss. So these lysosomes are the cell organelles which helps to destroy the foreign particles which enters into the cell. Okay, so as any germs or any foreign particles like that, what any germs or any bacteria enters in our body, then these are the cell organelles which destroy that foreign particles. Okay, also these lysosomes are called as suicidal bags. Now why is it so called as suicidal bag? Because in case if the any cell get damaged, then it can digest its own cell. Okay, so these lysosomes are called as suicidal bags. Why? Because if the cells get damaged, then these lysosomes digest that same cell or its own cell. Okay, so that is the work of the lysosome, and that is the reason it is called as what, suicidal bag. Means this lysosome eats its own cell, and that is the reason it is called as what, suicidal bag. So next one, and a very important point of the cell organelle that we will discuss, that is nothing but what, plastids. Okay, so these plastids are present only in the plant cells. Okay, so the plastids are present only in the plant cell, and it is absent in a animal cell. Okay, so these are the plastids present only in the plant cell and absent in a animal cell. So there are the different plastids are there, which gives the different colors, or there are the different functions in the proper functioning of the plants. Okay, and each and every plastid is having the different functions and the work. So let's discuss the one by one all the plastid. First we will discuss about the chloroplast. Okay, so this is the one type of the plastid. What is the name of that plastid? That is what, chloroplast. And this chloroplast plastid contains the green color pigment. Okay, so see here, this chloroplast is a green color plastid which contains the green color pigment, and the name of that green color pigment is nothing but what, chlorophyll. Okay, so where is the chlorophyll present? Chlorophyll is present in the chloroplast. Okay, so the chloroplast is a green color plastid, and it contains the green color pigment, that is nothing but what, chlorophyll. Okay, and this chlorophyll, as we know, this chlorophyll helps in the synthesis of food. For that only we are calling as what, photosynthesis. Okay, we are calling as what, photosynthesis. Okay, so this is the first plastid which is present in a plant cell. Next one we will discuss, that is chromoplast. Now what is meant by the chromoplast? This chromoplast is a non-green plastid, but it gives the color to flower and fruit. Okay, so this chromoplast is not in a green color, but as we know, the plant is having so many nice flowers are there, so many bright color flowers are there, yellow, pink, orange is there, red is there. So how these flowers and the fruits are getting the color? Because of this chromo. Chromo means what, color? Chromoplastid, but it is non-green color, and it gives the color to flower and fruit. And the next one we will discuss, that is what, leucoplast. So leucoplast is the third one plastid which is present in a plant cell, and this leucoplast is a colorless plastid, and it helps to store the food, or it helps to store in the storage of food. Okay, so these are the three plastids which are present only in a plant cell and absent in animal cell. First one we have discussed about the chloroplast. Chloroplast contains the green plastid, or it is a green plastid which contains the green pigment, that called as what, chlorophyll. And chlorophyll helps in the photosynthesis. Chromoplast are the non-green plastid which gives the color to the flower and fruit. And leucoplast are the colorless plastid, but they are helps in the storage of food. Now next one and the last one cell organelle will be discussed, that is what, centrosome. Okay, in the image you can see the centrosome, how it is exactly. So this centrosome is the, so this centrosome is located near the nucleus. Okay, this centrosome located near the nucleus and the centrosomes found only in animal cell. Okay, again there is one exception here. Okay, so see, these are the centrosome found only in an animal cell, and if it is present in animal cell, then they are near to the nucleus. Then what is the function of the centrosome? So this centrosome helps in the cell division. Okay, so the centrosome is involved in a cell division and found only in an animal cell. Okay, so these are the all cell organelles now we have discussed. Okay, so we have discussed today lysosomes, plastids, centrosomes. Lysosomes are called lysocidal bags. Plastids present only in a plant cell, and centrosome present only in an animal cell, and if it is present, it is located near the nucleus. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have finished this point, that is what, cell organelles. We'll meet in the next video, and in that video we will discuss about the comparison of the plant cell and the animal cell, and also we will discuss the last point, that is what, prokaryotic and the eukaryotic cell. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. It is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next concept, and for today, thank you.